laws we should follow and the importance of obeying God. Let us continue to learn about Moses and Israelites. So get ready to listen. Let's go!
Good morning, kids. Are you ready to hear another story today? Our story on Moses continues and we will see what happens next. But before we begin, I have one question for you. Have you ever been angry before? I know when I am angry, my face looks like this. And today, Moses may or may not have looked the same way. Before I tell you more, let's first come to the Lord in prayer. Put our hands together, bow down our heads, and close our eyes. Dear Lord, thank you for reminding us how merciful and just you are. Thank you for continually loving us. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. All right, now that we are set, let us grab our Bibles and open it to Exodus chapters 24, 32 to 34. God called Moses to the mountain for 40 days and 40 nights. During this time, he gave instructions regarding the tabernacle and the offerings. When God finished speaking to Moses on Mount Sinai, he gave him stone tablets inscribed by the very finger of God. They contained the 10 commandments. Meanwhile, the people of Israel had become impatient waiting for Moses to return with a message from God. Finally, the people gave up on him and begged Aaron to build them an altar so they could worship. Aaron answered them, "Take the gold earrings of your wives, your sons, and your daughters. Bring those earrings to me." All the people did so. He took what they gave him and made it into a metal statue of a god. It looked like a calf. He shaped it with a tool and told the people that there is the God who brought them out of Egypt. They held a festival and bowed down to worship their idol. So quickly, they had fallen back into the idolatry they were accustomed to in Egypt and disobeyed God's new commands. When Moses came down with the tablets of stone, his anger burned when he saw what the people had done. He threw down the two tablets and smashed it into pieces. He took the calf the people had made and burned it. He ground the gold into powder and scattered it with the water before making the Israelites drink it. Later, God instructed Moses to chisel two new stone tablets, just like the one he had written with his own finger. That ends our story for today. Today, we learned that although you and I are sinners, God is merciful and just. Now, let's take the time to reflect on our questions for today. Question 1. What did Aaron use to make the golden calf? Question 2. What did Moses do to the golden calf after seeing it? Question 3. Which commandment did the people disobey by making the calf?
Today's lesson has showed us that every time we sin, we make the Lord unhappy. But our verse for today reminds us of who our God is. 1 John chapter 1 verse 9, if we confess our sins, He is faithful and just and will forgive our sins and purify us from all righteousness. Have you memorized it? Let's recite it again together. 1 John chapter 1 verse 9, if we confess our sins, He is faithful and just and will forgive our sins and purify us from all unrighteousness. Remember, none of us are perfect, but the Lord cleanses us from all our impurities.
Hello everyone! For today's arts and craft, we will be making our My Heart craft. So, get ready with your arts and craft materials. A printed template, mungo beans, glue, and colored paper. Now we're ready for step 1. Paste the mungo beans inside the heart under my sins. Step 2. Paste some small pieces of colored paper inside the heart under God's mercy. And there you have it, our My Heart graph. This graph reminds us that we are all sinners, like the Israelites. But because God is merciful and just, we are forgiven and made pure when we ask for forgiveness. We hope you enjoyed our Sunday school today. We will see you next week. Bye!